Hi everybody, it's me. Welcome to the latest edition of COVIDios. This is the 29th, Sunday the 29th. And let me first start with my temperature. My temperature is 97.5 Fahrenheit or 36.4 Celsius. All right, I'm going to jump right in, and I want to talk a little bit about what my life has been like lately. And my life has been lately looking at exponential curves. And this is a little joke that was put up on my Facebook page about exponential curves. I think what I'm going to do today, even though we have a great number of cases, it is finally starting to, the hospitals are starting to accumulate patients in the state of Ohio. People are starting to get busy, and it's going to get very busy as we head into the storm. We are definitely on the verge of heading into the storm right now, and it's going to get a little bit rough. And hopefully we will all come out on the other side. But I want to focus on something else, and that is an exponential curve that I'm very happy to show you. This is a good curve, and we're looking at the number of people who are declared recovered, and that is going up, and that is going up at an exponential rate, and that is good news. The more people who are recovered, the better we are. The better we can, the more likely we are to return to normal. There's at least 140,000 people who have recovered, and this little picture here shows you a picture of when it was at 100. Things change on a daily basis. We're over 700,000 people in the world infected now. We are increasing in Ohio in a much faster rate. So I just want to point that out. Last thing I want to talk about is epidemics in general. One of the things that I can tell you, that I can promise you all, is that we will get out on the other side of this. We will recover. We will recover from this. And how can I be so certain? How can I be so absolutely certain? Because I've read the script. And the script is written in history. The history of epidemics, we've had a lot, and this one shows you a little bit of the epidemics that have been around, starting with smallpox and all kinds of plagues that have existed, and all of them have been defeated. There's a quote on here, a quote from Michael Crichton, and it says, life will find a way. And that certainly is true. That certainly is the case. We will find a way. We will all survive. Some of us will survive. That is one of the great things that happens in biodiversity. Because we are diverse, we have a way of surviving all kinds of plagues. Last thing is, this is a little bit late today, but I want to tell you I was outside and out looking at all the people and all kinds of stuff. And I want to remind you of how to be a helper. I followed through on my yesterday. I actually filed for a absentee ballot after the governor on Friday declared that we could get absentee ballots. And I did that, so I will be voting pretty soon. I also am working on the census. Haven't got that accomplished yet, but I will get to it. And other ways that you can help. This is Sunday, and I want to remind you that a lot of you go to church on Sundays, and a lot of you aren't going to church on Sundays. And churches, as it turns out, might be in a little bit of financial difficulty as a result of this. You can still find a way to give to churches. After all, they do good stuff like provide food for the hungry and such. Likewise, you can provide food at food pantries. Commodore Cupboard is our food pantry at the college. You can make a cash donation to the Commodore Cupboard. That is a good thing. There are people in need of food and have food insecurity now more than ever. So there are good opportunities. Also, if you're just sitting at home and you have some game, if you have some skills, if you can do something, like maybe you can crochet something, consider making a video and teach other people how to do it. Teach other people, if you have a great recipe for something. let me just do one more thing here, and I want to answer one question, and that question is, and I got this question off of this site, and the question is about takeout. And I will, I had something up on my webpage yesterday about, you know, how to deal sterile technique in your own house. I took it down because my Facebook page got hacked yesterday and I got rid of all the things. So if you're not on my Facebook page anymore, it's because I was hacked and I want to just get rid of all my recent additions. Basically what you do is you take a surface in your kitchen and you divide it into two. One is already cleaned. And then you unpack the food. Wash your hands first, unpack the food, and get it into receptacles that you can maybe microwave for a second. And try not to touch the food because you're touching the packages that it's in. Lots of food has packaging on it. And then you can microwave it for just a quick little bit, warm it up a bit. That should take care of everything. Heat is used to destroy everything we've ever encountered in the infectious disease world. And then you can go and wash, throw out the waste, and then wash your hands and enjoy your Big Mac or whatever it is that you got from the takeout store. All right, I'm gonna stop right there. I just wanna remind you all to be good to each other and may you persist like a lentivirus. Thank you.